तो मैम स्टार्ट करने से सबसे पहले हम ये जानना चाहते हैं, टेल अस अबाउट योर जर्नी, मतलब व्हाट मेड यू चूज दिस प्रोफेशन एंड हाउ यू स्टार्टेड ऑफ फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगिनिंग।
या एक्चुअली फ्रॉम वेरी बिगिनिंग आई हैड अ ड्रीम टू बिकम डॉक्टर, टू सर्व पीपल, टू ट्रीट पीपल. एंड सो आई हैव डन माई एम बी बी एस फ्रॉम एम जी एम मेडिकल कॉलेज, एम डी मेडिसिन
ओके
ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द सेम कॉलेज. एंड देन आई गॉट वेरी सून आई गॉट द जॉब ऑफ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर. देन आई बिकेम एसोशिएट प्रोफेसर एंड नाउ आई एम प्रोफेसर इन मेडिसिन. एंड आई लुक इन ऑल द फील्ड्स ऑफ मेडिसिन, बट स्पेशली आई एम प्रैक्टिसिंग इन न्यूरोलॉजी एंड हेड एक माइग्रेन. आई हैव अ स्पेशल ओपीडी ऑफ हेड एक माइग्रेन एंड न्यूरोलॉजी एवरी वीक इन आर हॉस्पिटल. एंड आई एम ऑल्सो
ओके
ट्रेन्ड बाय हेड एक स्पेशलिस्ट, दैट इज ओनली वी हैव ओनली वन हेड एक स्पेशलिस्ट इन इंडिया, दैट इज डॉक्टर रविशंकर इन मुंबई.
दैट्स ग्रेट।
ही इज इन चार्ज ऑफ हेड एक एंड माइग्रेन क्लिनिक इन लीलावती हॉस्पिटल एंड जसलोक हॉस्पिटल मुंबई. सो आई गॉट ट्रेनिंग फ्रॉम हिम ऑल्सो. सो दैट्स द
या
जर्नी.
दैट्स ग्रेट मैम, दैट्स ग्रेट। लाइक इट्स लाइक कि एमजीएम इंदौर इज लाइक होम फॉर यू ना, यू स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम देयर, यू कंप्लीट एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम देयर। मैम आई एक्चुअली लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स आर राइट नाउ प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर नीट पीजी एग्जाम्स, राइट? सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू नो दैट सिंस यू आर फ्रॉम अ गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, सो यू मस्ट बी वेरी स्टूडियस फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगिनिंग। सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू नो दैट हाउ यू यूज टू स्टडी एंड हाउ यू यूज टू प्रिपेयर फॉर योर एग्जाम्स ड्यूरिंग योर एग्जाम डेज।
एक्चुअली आई यूज टू वी यूज मीन्स वी डोंट डिपेंड ओनली ऑन एम सी क्यू बुक्स. वी हैव टू रीड आर टेक्स्ट बुक्स ऑल्सो. एंड वाइल रीडिंग होल चैप्टर आफ्टर दैट वी कैन वॉट आर द की पॉइंट्स, वॉट आर द क्वेश्चन विच आर कमिंग इन एग्जामिनेशन. वी कैन मेक नोट्स ऑफ इट और वी कैन स्टिक अ पेपर एंड इन बुक ओनली एंड वी कैन राइट वॉट इज कमिंग. सो वी कैन रिवाइज दैट. एंड वी हैव टू रीड वन टॉपिक एज सून एज मीन्स इन लेस टाइम. एंड वी शुड गिव मोर टाइम फॉर रिविजन बिकॉज इन वन टाइम ऑफ रीडिंग वी डोंट ग्रास्प एवरीथिंग. सो एज मोर रिविजन्स वी हैव मोर गुड इज द रिजल्ट.
सो बेसिकली द थिंग इज दैट वी शुड कीप ऑन रिवाइजिंग थिंग्स व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड, राइट?
रीड फास्ट एंड देन गिव द टाइम फॉर रिविजन.
And ma'am, there is one more thing. Like we all are very much aware of that medicine is a very bright branch and it's a very good branch. But being a woman, like we live in a society for say that being a woman, you have to manage your work, manage your houses as well. So can you tell us the cons of this profession, choosing MD medicine? How does it? It is a challenging in your life.
एक्चुअली एमडी मेडिसिन वॉज माई चॉइस. आई वॉज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन सर्जिकल ब्रांचेस. सो इट इज़ अ वास्ट ब्रांच इंक्लूडिंग कार्डियोलॉजी, न्यूरोलॉजी, गैस्ट्रोएंट्रोलॉजी एंड मेकिंग अ डायग्नोसिस एंड ट्रीटिंग. इट्स रियली वेरी नाइस. सो आई एम हैप्पी विद दैट. एंड बट या वी हैव टू मैनेज द हाउस एंड वर्क बिकॉज इट हैज मोर इमरजेंसीज, मेनली आईसीयूज एंड देर आर इमरजेंसीज, बट आई हैव टू मैनेज दैट.
And ma'am, what are the most common presentation that you see in the OPDs these days?
मोस्ट कॉमन प्रेजेंटेशंस आर मेनली स्ट्रोक पेशेंट्स आर कमिंग, ऑफ पास्ट स्ट्रोक्स और न्यू पेशेंट्स विथ वीकनेस. देन पेशेंट्स ऑफ हेड एक आर कमिंग. देन कार्डियक पेशेंट्स विथ एंजाइना और मायोकार्डियल इन्फार्क्शन और पास्ट हिस्ट्री ऑफ मायोकार्डियल इन्फार्क्शन, दे आर कमिंग मोर. देन सिंपल पेशेंट्स ऑफ फीवर, दे ऑल्सो कम.
So more of the story like heart patients are very much and so ma'am, let's start with the migraine, ma'am. We were about to discuss about the migraine. Ma'am, tell us about the very beginning and basic
So
things.
headache is a very common.
Yes, ma'am.
Headache is a very common problem in OPD, in medicine OPD as well as neurology OPDs. And headache is divided mainly into primary headache and secondary headache. Secondary headache in which there is some cause which is causing headache. For example, there is some general infection. There is some systemic infections like meningitis, encephalitis. देर इज ब्रेन ट्यूमर और देर इज वेस्क्यूलर पैथोलॉजी, एनी कॉज इज देयर, देन इट इज कॉजिंग हेडेक, देन इट इज नोन एज सेकेंडरी हेडेक. एंड वॉट इज प्राइमरी हेडेक, इट इट डज नॉट हैव एनी अंडरलाइंग डिसीज और एनी अंडरलाइंग पैथोलॉजी. And the most common is tension type headache, and second most common is migraine. So now we deal with the migraine. Migraine is a benign neurological condition which has repeated episodes of headache.
Mm-hmm.
And this repeated episodes of headache are associated with different neurological dysfunction, different features of neurological dysfunction. And it is a benign condition, but it is recurrent condition. And you would not be knowing it that migraine is coming in top 10 list of disability causing diseases in the world. That is top 10 disability causing diseases of the world has migraine. Migraine also has a place in that list. So it is a very disabling patient, has features of vertigo, visual disturbances, dizziness, all these features patient are having with headache. So it is very troublesome problem, and patients used to they are not able to attend their activities, like they are not able to attend their workplaces, their occupational activities, their social activities. Students are missing their colleges and schools. So it is among the top 10 disability causing, top 10 causes of disability, migraine is coming in that. And more interesting thing is it is under-treated and it is under-diagnosed. It is not easily diagnosed. It is under-diagnosed and under-treated, and burden is very high. Now we come to symptoms of migraine. Before coming to symptoms, we should know that it is a genetic disease. It has a strong genetic association. While seeing a patient of migraine, we should ask, do your parents have similar type of headache? Or your siblings, your brother or sister is having this type of headache. So many times we get the history, yes, my sister is also having similar type of headache. My father is also having this type of headache, but it is milder or severe. So we should ask about genetic history. It usually starts at the younger age group, that is around 20 years of the age, and it decreases after 55 years of the age. So if a patient comes with headache after 55 years of the age, which is resembling migraine, we should think for other causes. Like there may be brain tumor or vascular cause can be there. We come to symptoms of migraine. In symptoms of migraine, we have to follow international classification of headache disorders, in which out of four characteristics of headache, we must have two. These four characteristics are unilateral headache, moderate to severe headache. Migraine has moderate to severe headache. It is not mild. Then throbbing. Throbbing is pulsating. So there is pulsating type of feature, throbbing type of feature is there, and increase with activity. So a patient of a headache of migraine patient increases with activities like walking, doing work, and it decreases with rest. So a patient of migraine, what does he like? Whenever he has headache, patient likes to sleep in a closed dark room, because light is also causing problem, and patient's headache is somewhat relieved in resting position. So these four characteristics, unilateral, throbbing, moderate to severe in intensity, and aggravated by movement. Out of this, two features should be present to diagnose migraine. Then associated features. In associated features, out of two, one should be present. So first is nausea and or vomiting. And second one is photophobia and phonophobia. So photophobia, either patient should have nausea and or vomiting. Or photophobia and phonophobia. This is also common complaint. In photophobia, person has intolerance to light. And in phonophobia, patient has intolerance to sounds. So that is phonophobia. Then we come to other symptoms. Other symptoms patient may have, like visual disturbances, dizziness, giddiness, or diarrhea patient can have. Then we have migraine without aura and migraine with aura. So this all we discussed is migraine without aura. That is more common. That is 80%. And the second thing is migraine with aura. This which is less common. That is 20%. And aura is mainly visual. We can have visual aura, sensory aura, motor aura. And most common aura is visual. In visual aura, patient sees flashes of light. That is flashes of light or zigzag lines of light patient sees. And patient can also see scotoma. Scotoma is central scotoma is if you are seeing a scenery. For example, you are seeing a building. So in a building, all the periphery is visible, and in the center it is not visible. It is blurred. So central vision is blurred for some time. So that is central scotoma. So patient can have scotoma. Patient can have flashes of light, zigzag lines before headache starts. So that is aura, visual aura. Patient can have sensory aura in the form of tingling or numbness in any part of the body. So these are troublesome symptoms. A patient gets frightened. Ki patient is having dizziness, giddiness, severe headache. So patient is unable to continue his activities at workplace and social activities. Then we come to investigations. Then we come to trigger. Trigger is very important in migraine. Different patients have different triggers. Not all the patients have same trigger. So these triggers are the things which precipitate migraine. A person is having migraine, but it is controlled. Whenever there is trigger, patient again starts having headache. For example, loud sounds. So if a person goes in a market and there are loud sounds, so migraine again starts. Then sunlight or bright lights. Some people say that whenever they go to sun, they in sunlight they have a headache. And some people say that they have, if they go to a movie, there are changing lights and that precipitate headache. Then hunger. Hunger is a very common precipitating factor. If a person miss a meal. If a person miss a breakfast, he starts headache at around 2 p.m. In afternoon, patient can have start headache. Then other triggers are travel. Travel also causes headache. And change in weather. Weather, summer season has more headache. A person says whenever there is summer, I have more headache for 2 to 3 months. And then when the season change, it gets relieved. Then smoking also causes precipitate headache. Then alcohol intake and wine, that also precipitates headache and migraine. Caffeine intake, more caffeine a person takes, that can also precipitate headache. And last but not the least is physical exertion, which is not routine for a person. If a person do extra physical exertion or mental stress. So patient should avoid these triggers. Patient should identify what is my trigger. So whatever the trigger is, if a person have headache after alcohol, patient should avoid it. If a person has headache in sunlight, they should have goggles and cap, and they should try to avoid it. So in this way, trigger should be avoided. Then we come to investigation. There is no clear, there is no biochemical marker which diagnoses migraine. There is no MRI finding that diagnoses migraine. Migraine is a clinical condition. So we have to diagnose it clinically, but we do MRI of the brain or CT scan of the brain to rule out other causes, because we don't know. Sometimes symptoms are resembling other serious conditions like a brain tumor, like vascular conditions. So we should rule out other diseases. We should do an MRI. In certain conditions, MRI is extremely necessary. These are, if a headache is starting, new onset headache after the 55 years of age, that is old age, new headache has started. So we should always, there is some problem. There must may be any cerebrovascular stroke, or there may be any tumor. So we should go for MRI brain. Then if a person is having a severe first onset headache, that is first worst headache, that is seen in subarachnoid hemorrhage. In subarachnoid hemorrhage, patient describes, it is written in books, first worst headache. मीन्स इट इज़ वेरी सीवियर एंड फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैव नोटिस्ड इट, तो वी शुड गो फॉर MRI. देन अ पर्सन हु इज़ हैविंग फीवर, बिकॉज इन अ पेशेंट ऑफ फीवर मेनिंजाइटिस कैन बी कॉज ऑफ हेडेक, सो इन फीवर ऑल्सो वी शुड गो डू अ इमेजिंग. देन अ पर्सन इफ अ पर्सन इज हैविंग अदर सीरियस कंडीशंस लाइक मेलिग्नेंसी और इम्यूनो कॉम्प्रोमाइज स्टेटस लाइक HIV, इन दैट कंडीशंस ऑल्सो वी शुड गो फॉर इमेजिंग. देन वी कम टू ट्रीटमेंट. इन ट्रीटमेंट फर्स्ट इज लाइफ स्टाइल मैनेजमेंट. सो इन लाइफ स्टाइल मैनेजमेंट पेशेंट शुड हैव रेगुलर मील्स, नो मील शुड बी स्किप्ड. पेशेंट शुड हैव बैलेंस्ड डाइट. देन पेशेंट शुड हैव रेगुलर स्लीप. स्लीप इज ऑल्सो अ ट्रिगर. इफ अ पर्सन हैव मोर स्लीप देन इट इज ऑल्सो ट्रिगर. इफ पर्सन हैव लेस स्लीप देन यूजल दैट इज ऑल्सो अ ट्रिगर. So a person should have normal sleep, regular meals should be there, lifestyle modifications like yoga and exercise should also be there, and then we come to pharmacological management. In pharmacological management there is acute treatment and there is preventive treatment. So in acute treatment we can give NSAIDs and we can give triptans. So these are commonly used triptans are triptan, rizatriptan. So, but these triptans are contraindicated in vasoconstrictor diseases like cerebrovascular accidents, stroke, coronary artery disease. It is and peripheral vascular disease. It is contraindicated. So, it is contraindicated in CAD, CVA, and peripheral vascular disease. In other conditions, we can give it. It acts faster. Then preventive therapy should not be started for all the patients. Preventive therapy should be started for selective patient whom migraine is severe. Patient is having more than 5 episodes per month. So more than 5 episodes per month a patient is having, then we can start a prophylactic treatment. Or headache is very severe, requiring hospitalization or visual blurring, then we should start preventive therapy. So in preventive therapy you would have heard that we can give propranolol, beta blocker. Then we can give, and out of anti-epileptics we can give topiramate and we can give divalproic sodium. Then amitriptyline is tricyclic antidepressant drug which can also be used in migraine prophylaxis, and fluorazine, that is a calcium channel blocker. This amitriptyline is a known as magic drug. It is used in many conditions. It is used in migraine. It is used in depression in more doses, and it is used also in peripheral neuropathies. So it is a magic drug. Whenever a patient comes, who has some sort of depression also, especially female having depression also, migraine also, so we can start that. Then sometimes we have a combination of tension type headache and migraine. So there also it works. So it works in tension type headache, it works in migraine, it works in peripheral neuropathy, it works in depression. So it can be used. This prophylactic drug should be used for at least first its effect comes in 2 months, and then it should be continued for at least 6 months. 6 to 7 months it should be given. And then we can slowly, we have to withdraw these drugs. Then newer drugs are coming, monoclonal antibodies that are CGRP blockers. So these drugs would be are not available, but they would be given subcutaneously once a month. So that would bring some revolution in the treatment. They are more efficient than this older drugs. So this is migraine, and the most common differential diagnosis is tension type headache. Tension type headache is just opposite of it. In tension type headache, there is headache is bilateral, it is mild, whereas in migraine it is moderate. And it is bilateral, and it does not increase with activity. It relieves with activity. So, and there can be nausea but no vomiting. There can be photophobia or phonophobia. One of them can be present. So tension type headache is milder form and they don't report to hospitals. That is milder. They get relieved with on-counter medications. So people coming to hospital, tertiary hospitals mainly are migraine patients. So in migraine patient, they have to identify the triggers and they can be started on appropriate drugs according to their condition. So there is no 100% cure for migraine. It can be controlled, and with any of the treatment, it is controlled only 60 to 70%. So whenever a patient come, we should at the first visit only when we are planning treatment, we should tell him कि यू डोंट थिंक कि विद ऑल दिस ट्रीटमेंट आई विल बी रिलीव्ड 100%. इट इज ओनली रिलीफ विल बी ओनली रुपए में 70% फर्क पड़ेगा, है ना? ऐसा 100% नहीं पड़ेगा और कभी कभी तो दर्द होगा ही. तो दैट शुड बी एक्सप्लेन एट फर्स्ट विजिट ओनली. सो द पेशेंट इज ऑल्सो काम एंड टेक्स SOS मेडिकेशन ऑल्सो. सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट माइग्रेन.
थैंक यू सो मच मैम, बहुत अच्छे से समझाया आपने. एंड द सेकंड थिंग इज लाइक कि माइग्रेन में मैम काउंसलिंग भी बहुत बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट रोल प्ले करता होगा ना. काउंसलिंग
यस यस
प्लेज वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन दैट आल्सो ना.
यस
मैम
यस
देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन पॉपिंग अप लाइक हाउ टू मेंटेन नॉर्मलसी इफ वन इज इनटू अ मेडिकल प्रोफेशन एंड सराउंडेड बाय इमरजेंसीज ऑल द टाइम टू अवॉइड ट्रिगर्स.
हाउ टू मेंटेन नॉर्मल
हाउ
नॉर्मलसी.
टू हाँ टू अवॉइड ट्रिगर्स.
अच्छा
हाँ
ओके ओके
टू अवॉइड ट्रिगर्स इफ वन इज इनटू द मेडिकल प्रोफेशन सराउंडेड बाय द इमरजेंसीज ऑल द टाइम.
ओके
लाइक द क्वेश्चन इज शी वांट टू आस्क कि इफ अ डॉक्टर इज अ माइग्रेन इफ डॉक्टर हैव माइग्रेन देन हाउ ही कैन अवॉइड द ट्रिगर्स. सो व्हाट शुड व्हाट प्रिकॉशंस ही कैन टेक ही और शी कैन टेक.
सो इट इज मेनली प्रेजेंट इन यंगर एज ग्रुप एंड दे शुड सिलेक्ट सब्जेक्ट ऑल्सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट विच डज नॉट हैव सो मच ऑफ इमरजेंसीज. और इफ दे आर वेरी कीन फॉर वन सब्जेक्ट कि आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन दिस सब्जेक्ट ओनली, सो दे कैन डू दैट सब्जेक्ट बिकॉज इन डूइंग पीजी देर इज लॉट ऑफ वर्क, बट आफ्टर डूइंग पीजी दे कैन डू वॉट एवर मीन्स हाउ मच दे वॉन्ट टू प्रैक्टिस. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन देम. इफ अ
राइट
गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट इज देयर, दे कैन सी कि वो हाउ मच प्रैक्टिस वी कैन डू. सो इट
राइट
डज नॉट हैव प्रॉब्लम. And rest of the triggers which are avoidable, that should be avoided.
seems very long in the go
There is a question
for
that
the
there is a
मैम इट्स अ क्वेश्चन दैट इज देयर एन इंक्रीज्ड रिस्क ऑफ स्ट्रोक फॉर माइग्रेन
योर
सफरर्स.
वॉइस इज नॉट क्लियर.
मैम द क्वेश्चन इज दैट इज देयर एनी इंक्रीज्ड रिस्क ऑफ स्ट्रोक फॉर माइग्रेन सफरर्स.
दिस वाज आवर थीसिस लास्ट ईयर दैट स्टूडेंट हैज नॉट स्टिल पास्ड. डॉक्टर चंद्रांश पाटीदार, वी डिड अ थीसिस इन पेशेंट्स ऑफ स्ट्रोक. वी फाउंड आउट हाउ मेनी हैव माइग्रेन. So there is increased risk of migraine, increased risk of stroke among migraineurs, especially ischemic stroke is more common among migraines and more in females.
And there is no more questions regarding such things. So we'll wait for the questions. Till then, ma'am, what I was asking that you must have colleagues practicing in the private sector as well. So, how do you find your life different from their practice? Is there any difference between a government sector practicing and in private sector practicing?
Both are good. People who are practicing in private, they are master of their own. They can plan their activities, they can plan their procedures in the morning, they can take leave whenever they want. But in government practice, we have sudden meetings, we have to attend lot of meetings, lot of commissions we have to do, and our time morning to afternoon is blocked. So
You
that
have
is
more
the
workload on yourself, right?
yeah
And yes, Sarthak is saying that thanks a lot, ma'am. My mother once took your treatment for 6 months and she never had a migraine attack again.
oh
Wow.
thank you very much. thanks
And there's one more question that does weather affect migraine?
Weather
Does weather
affects migraine. in summer season migraine.
अच्छा
Yeah, in summer season migraine for 3 to 4 months migraine is severe.
ओके
So
यस मैम एंड मूविंग ऑन मैम अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस कैन यू टेल अस समथिंग अबाउट योर पीजी डेज लाइक हाउ वाज इट लाइक इट इज सेइंग दैट इन पीजीस ड्यूरिंग पीजीस टाइम इट इज वेरी हेक्टिक एंड द पीपल गो थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेस सो कैन यू शेयर सम स्टोरी ऑफ दैट योर पीजी डेज दैट हाउ स्ट्रेस्ड यू वर एंड हाउ डू यू कोप अप विद दैट ऑल दिस थिंग्स सो दैट द आवर such so that the neat PGS friends like me and the many of us who is watching this can get a lesson from get a blurred picture of it.
Actually what happens in MBBS days a person does not have to do any physical work. They are their own boss. They get up at their own time. They sleep at their own time. But when you get in the busy you are just under a department. So you have to work there very hard. Your seniors will tell what you have to do. And this much of physical exertion and mental stress is a person is not ready, not very much adjustable to that. So slowly it gets adjusted. In first year, a person loses weight because we have to run here and there. So a person who was a good healthy person in MBBS loses his weight in first year. So in second year it's somewhat cool. First year is very hectic in all the subjects. First year you have to work very hard. You have to counsel the patients. You are the first. You are the first person in contact of the patient. First year student. First year PGs. So they have to take the blood. In those doing surgeries, they have to do all the arrangement for the patient, whether the blood is arranged or not. And they should be ready for everything. From second year, they have to study, especially in medicine pediatric branches. They have to study more and what's the diagnosis, differential diagnosis. So that is more. So a person adjusts well. It takes 1, 2 to 3 months, but a person adjusts well. And for that, you can practice some yoga or meditation from now on so and after doing your PG also for 10 to 15 minutes you can do meditation
meditation so and yeah we need to get into the practice of all these things before getting into the PG right so ma'am there is one more question popping up it said that the does migraine have a hormonal role
it is more during menses and it decreases during pregnancy It is more during menses, so that is known as catamenial migraine. So, a patient complains that at every time, every month of her time of her period, she is having migraine. So, so the treatment is we have to start preventive therapy and we have to start sumatriptan before her date of menses, and we should continue for the period of menses. So, that is a hormonal role.
Okay. Yeah, so that's all for the migraine, and there's no more questions popping up. So, ma'am, there's one more question if you like to answer it. That any effective treatment for hypothyroidism plus migraine? I guess the person need to contact you in OPD.
Okay. Hypothyroidism. I don't know. There is some association between hypothyroidism and migraine. So both are different things. So, but obesity also obesity has an association with migraine. Metabolic syndrome and obesity has an association. For here, for we have to give migraine treatment for migraine differently, and we have to give for hypothyroid we have to replace thyroxine hormone.
Right.
So both the things are different. We should do that.
Shivendra is asking that migraine also has one-sided head pain. Migraine also has one-sided head pain as the symptoms. Of course, it does. One-sided head pain.
I have told you now there are four characteristics of headache, out of which two should be present, and this in this four there is unilateral also. So if it is not unilateral and other features are present, like it is bilateral, moderate to severe, and throbbing, then also we can make the diagnosis of migraine. It is not compulsory that it should be unilateral only.
Okay.
But mostly it is unilateral.
Unilateral, right?
Yeah.
Or ma'am, before binding up, I would just like to thank you once again, and just want to tell you that please give a message for all the students who is watching us right now. for the PG aspirants at the second third year students.
I am also very thankful to you and your team for inviting me and letting me interact with you. And I want you all study very well and get subject of your choices. So you study fast, revise fast, and you you should get what subjects you need. So you should all blossom in life and live a happy life. So that is my wish for all of you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. We'll keep coming with you and keep on talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.